một số lúc thì mình đã bị đau cơ tử vì bỏ bữa.
No, not yet.
I don't usually eat breakfast.
After watching the intro, do you remember our project? Yep, it's about adolescent nutrition.
So last week we was really happy to receive a congratulation email from Vietnam Amazing Students.
And right after that, we started planning for the first week activities.
So here is what we have done. Follow us!
This week, we determined the area where we will collect the data and will implement our proposed solution in the long run. So we decided to mainly focus on three high schools in Binh Hoa City, which are Luong Hiep Binh High School for Gifted, Ngo Quyen High School and Trung Binh High School. Then we prepared 10 questions about adolescent nutrition. After that, we made a Google form for the survey and also interviewed some students and their parents to collect community's understanding on this topic. So, let's get started!
Introduce yourself.
Okay, I'm 17 and I am a student at Luong Hiep Binh High School for the Gifted.
How old are you?
17.
I'm 16.
I'm 16 too.
I'm 16.
Mình tên là Lê Thị Kim Chi, mình học là học sinh lớp 11A13 của trường Trung học phổ thông Trung Biên.
Mình là Thảo Nguyên, mình học ở trường Trung học phổ thông Ngô Quyền lớp 11A5.
How often do you skip your meals?
Actually, to be honest, I always skip my meals. I don't usually eat breakfast.
I think I never skip.
Not usually, but sometimes, like today, I skip.
Có. Thỉnh thoảng mình mới bỏ bữa.
What are the reasons for your skipping meals?
I think that I don't have enough time to prepare for my meals before getting to school. And on Sunday, I usually, because I am sleepy, so yeah, I skip it.
Maybe twice a week when I'm busy or I wake up late.
How about you?
I miss my meal because I wake up late and I don't have money to buy my meal.
Usually I skip lunch, but today I skip breakfast because there's no food in the canteen and it's just don't feel very hungry.
Lý do mình thường bỏ bữa là do mỗi lần mà đi học về thì mình cảm thấy rất là mệt và sau đó là đi ngủ trưa nên mình đã bỏ qua bữa trưa của mình.
Mình thường sẽ có một vài hôm là sẽ đi học trễ cho nên là mình không có kịp ăn.
And have you ever adopted a healthy eating planner or a meal planner?
A couple of years ago, I did make a plan for my meals and did it for 2 weeks, but yeah, I ended it now.
Not really, because at home, my mother or grandma just, they cook, I eat whatever they cook for me.
Maybe.
No,
not yet.
Actually, no, but I have had planned some schedule of having a healthy eating diet, but never stick to it.
Mình đã có suy nghĩ đến nhưng mà vẫn chưa thực hiện được.
Mình cũng đã từng nghĩ tới nhưng mà chưa có cơ hội để thử.
Well, what obstacle have you met when maintaining a healthy way of eating?
I guess the way how the meals fit me, like how you choose the food and how it's cooperate with each other.
It seems tasteless, right?
Yes.
Like you see so many delicious food that are unhealthy, but that you won't eat them.
Yes, that you have to follow strict rules, like you must not eat too much carbs and need to have a balanced meal and consist of many components, and this quite challenging for me to have some sort of of challenge like that?
Thường thì mình tập trung vào việc học rất là nhiều cho nên là mình sẽ quên đi những bữa ăn và không có thời gian để tập trung vào đó.
Mình lười.
So what do you think of the impact of adolescent nutrition on your study, lifestyle, or your relationships?
As a high school student, I think that we have to need nutrition before we study. And it's really have a positive impact on our academic performances if you have enough nutrition before you get into school.
Okay. I think nutrition have a huge impact because, for example, you cannot study well if you are hungry. If you eat healthy, you will have a fit body, and maybe people will like you a lot more.
But we know it's important that we can maintain our healthy diet.
Having meals which is not nutritious can affect students' life, like it can reduce the confidence and the way the students eat and trying to focus on the lessons.
Mình thấy là nó ảnh hưởng khá là lớn. Tại vì những có một số lúc thì mình đã bị đau bao tử vì bỏ bữa.
Mình sẽ cảm thấy là cả người không còn sức lực này để học hết. Bình thường sẽ cảm thấy mệt mỏi, nhanh mệt mỏi và hơi buồn ngủ nữa.
In your opinion, what makes up a healthy and balanced meal?
I think that it depends on each person. Like every person has their own nutrition needs, so and also they also need to have advice from experts, so yeah, they can build up a good meal for them.
Maybe it is a meal that consists of a lot of kinds of nutrition, vitamins and vegetables.
It contains nutrition. We should have many vegetables, fruit.
A healthy and balanced meal consists of a diverse and full of nutrition items, like you have to have carbs, proteins, a little bit fat, and of course some fiber just to boost your digestive system and helps your body maintaining a good health.
Theo mình thì mình nghĩ là nên ăn ít những đồ có dầu mỡ và nên bổ sung chất xơ cho cơ thể nhiều hơn.
Chất chúng ta ăn phải có sự cân bằng, chứ không phải chất nào cũng tốt, nhưng mà cái mỗi thứ mình phải cân bằng một chút. Chất rau, chất thịt, chất tôm, chất cá, chất đều thuộc về tự nhiên mà mình tự chế biến lấy thì điều đó là tốt nhất. Nó tránh được những cái gia vị không cần thiết, đôi khi nó làm ức chế cái hệ tiêu hóa, có thể là sẽ cho nó thiếu đi sự khỏe mạnh. Cần những thức ăn tươi